All right, here we go. Arpin, who finished second in Utah, currently second in points, going against Andreas Bakkerud, our tire technician here, as he was the fastest today. So again, two very different driving styles, two different vehicles. What are your thoughts?
Well, look what Robin said. He goes, look, he got an extra 8 laps. Now, nobody knew that was coming. It wasn't like a bonus for the thing. No. It was just Yokohama were like, we want to try something. We want to pick a car. The only way we can do this is we're going to pick the fastest guy. That was what they did. It's not a bad choice. You're backwards, out and out Rallycross Pro against Arpin here off the line. Great start for Subaru, but the Hyundai on the inside has got a brilliant start too. Backwards going to try and make the car back. Arpin tries to keep it shut.
Oh, gets into the wet. Here we go. So there's that big... So look at that. No Tanner Faust mode there. We're switching to Tanner. Like, go to the moon. And look at Arpin. Wide swing. Bakkerud could have struck there, but as Travis was talking about, longer cars. So they're fast, they're quick, but they're long. So they got that wide swing.
They're stable. You know, there's definitely a bit of extra stability. And Bakkerud is very comfortable in a big car. Don't forget he did a couple of seasons with Hooligan Racing Division in the Focus RS RX, which was also a longer wheelbase car. So Bakkerud now, for me, I would joker if I were him, definitely. Arpin could, I think if Arpin dummied him and went to joker on lap one, Bakkerud will just see it. It's not the same as it was in Utah. Yes, so Bakkerud's gone in. He looked to me like he had an edgy bit of pace over Arpin on that previous lap. Now he's got to really nail it. It was 0.2, what is it now? 3.1, so it's 2.9. 2.9 is roughly what the joker is. So Bakkerud needs to be within that if he wants to take Arpin. Arpin now's got a choice of whether he responds or waits, Jared.
And we're talking about the Subaru, the length of it. I mean, he almost Austin powered that thing going in that Yokohama Joker lap, right? You can just park that thing sideways and get stuck in there. It is very narrow and precarious. So you're kind of tiptoeing through there to make sure you don't hit the wall and cause some damage to your car. Arpin gains some more ground, 3.3 seconds as he's pulling away from Bakkerud.
Yeah, he's taking another tenth of him here. Looks he's gone by 0.2. Now by 0.3. If I were Arpin, I might be tempted to go this lap. You know you've got it. Don't wait and make a mistake on the next lap. Not that he would, but it's hedge your bets, Jared. You know, you've had a good lap. That's 2.8. Lost 6 tenths already. Probably gone. Backwards got him on that last sector. Arpin's going to go in now. Watch for Andreas on the inside line. Going to be super close between them. And no, Arpin just hooked on.
Yeah. Arpin came out and he kind of pulled what Bakkerud did towards the latter portion of that joker. Like you said, kind of get out of shape, flirt with that wall. And that wall, as we've seen throughout today, is not forgiving at all. So Arpin airs it out pretty big there as Bakkerud trying to track him down. Less than half a second, Arpin scrubs some speed. Bakkerud tries to dive in. Oh, we got contact.
Trying, just letting him know he's there, isn't he? He's desperate for Steve now to run deep, make a mistake. There isn't the corner that we had at Utah where lots of people were running that little bit deep. And I'm not convinced he's going to find a way through here, Jared.
You know what? You know what I'm seeing here. You talked about it earlier. Just the track changing color, dark brown to light brown. That top line is getting very pale, and it's looking very dry. And wow, look at that! Absolute hits.
Hit him three times, I reckon. There, one on the way. Nothing untoward again. Just letting him know, but it's too late. Steve Arpin's done this. Going to come up, jump over the line, take the checker. Arpin goes through, and Bakkerud goes out. So yeah, done.
Whew. That was a good race. I like that, and I think that's. That's how we want to see the battles really close, you know, nobody crashing out. No, I mean, obviously contact there towards the end, letting you know kind of shots fired across the nose. But from the start, Arpin did really well against some momentum coming from Utah, getting second place, you know, with being bookended with two handsome bros on either side, first and third. But Bakkerud, he is the first I've seen get to the water right there.
Yeah, and it didn't help, did it? If you look, it sucked that front right wheel in and it cost him a car length. Now, car length doesn't look like much, but would a car length have been enough to get up the inside there? Every little tenth of a second counts.
There's Bakkerud airing it over on the far side of the track.
The gaps were weird, Jared. You know, we saw it when he went up to 2.8, didn't it? And then suddenly, you know, he had it at 3.5 somewhere. Arpin lost 7 tenths of a second. I was like, he's done. He went in there with only 2.6, and yet still came out. Bakkerud look has held the inside line here, and I wonder he could have run the car a bit wider, but I still don't think he would have got him. Yeah, if he'd used all the track on the exit.
We saw Kevin Erickson take a really tight line there when he went against Fraser McConnell, but I think that was the right line, the one that Kevin had. But like you said, just getting that big chassis sideways, it's getting a lot of, you know, it's slowing it down considerably.
I think those alternate lines aren't quite there. When you had Travis up here, Travis has been here before. You know, I know Bakkerud was at the test as well, but Travis He was saying when the line comes in and we've got the full width, you'll have real options. We'll see a lot of passing. And at the minute, let's say you've got 50 to 75% of the line is clean. It's just not quite enough to exploit those options, you know, to really to make a gap, to find a way through. So, yeah, Bakkerud's out.
Yeah. Yeah, Bakkerud out early in the 16. Up next, we have two more battles. Scott Speed and Kavith Bigham, followed Ham, and then finally we got Ollie Eriksson and Liam Doran. What's the smile
about? I'm just looking forward to Ollie Eriksson versus Liam Doran. Like, Liam in any battle is always good. But Liam's so fired up about this track. He absolutely loves it. You know, Robin's gone through from the round one. The cartel had a really rough event down in Utah. They really did. It did not go their way at all. This was Bakkerud just putting a bit of pressure on. He's not going to push him round because Andreas knows he'll immediately get DQ'd for that. But Jared, it's that nudge. I'm here, nudge. I'm annoying, nudge. And then you watch the mirrors. And if you get them driving on their mirrors, they're not looking where they're going. Then they make a mistake and you open the door. So he's just knocking on the door. That's all it is.
Yeah, a little more than that. He's poking the bear is what he's doing.